स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस वीडियो वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट एक्सरसाइज 4.2 क्वेश्चन नंबर 3 ऑनवर्ड्स। वी विल कंप्लीट दिस एक्सरसाइज इन दिस वीडियो, सो स्टे कनेक्टेड एंड वॉच दिस वीडियो टिल एंड। आई एम गोइंग टू स्टार्ट थर्ड क्वेश्चन एंड सी व्हाट इज गिवन हियर। थर्ड क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड टू नंबर्स हुज सम इज 27 एंड प्रोडक्ट इज 182। सो देयर आर टू नंबर्स, नथिंग इज गिवन हियर, बट वन थिंग इज वेरी क्लियर, सम ऑफ दीज टू नंबर्स, देयर आर टू नंबर्स, sum of these two numbers is this number, but we don't know any number. One more thing, their product means if we multiply them, their product is 182. So we have their product equal to 182. What are the numbers? We want to find numbers. Let's start with one variable. Suppose first number is x. Since this total, their combination is 27, so 27 is more, then what will be the other number? Just take example. If first number is 7, what will be the other number? That will be 20, because 20 plus 7 will give 27. So we can take one example like this. So we have to write here now second number. So that will be 27, means total minus first number. That will be your second number. Then they have given their product is equal to 182. So we have to multiply these two and their product will be 182. This will be starting of our equation. Then we will solve it further for answers. So see, I am going to start its answer now. So we have sum of two numbers. Sum of two numbers is given equal to 27. Let first number equal to x. Therefore, what will be the second one? Second number, it will be 27 minus x. But in question it is given their product means first number into second number, their product is 182. So we have to solve this and it will give one quadratic equation. We will solve that further for answers and we will try to give answers in the end for these two lines, first number, second number. So start it, 27x, multiply x inside, minus x square equal to 182. Since this x square is negative, so I will shift this to the right side. Accordingly, I will shift this 27 to the right side. So it will be 0 equal to x square will become positive there. This 27 negative with minus sign. Okay, we have tried this x. Then 182 was positive there, so it is same. Now rewrite it. The same is equal to 0, so write it in the left side. So x square minus 27x plus 182 equal to 0. Now first and last, their product is 182, means as we always do, in the same way I am writing, 182 x square. Now you have to factorize this minus 27 x in two parts, so that their product gives 182 and their sum gives 27. What are the numbers? They are 14 and 13. So I have to write it as minus 14 minus 13, because minus 14 x into minus 13x, it will give 182 x square. So this is a rough work, you can mark it, otherwise you can ignore it as you wish you can do. So I'm going to write it now here, x square minus 14x minus 13x plus 182 equal to 0. Or from first to and last to take values common, from first to x common x minus 14, from last to minus 13 common x minus 14. Now x minus 14 is the common factor. And what is left with you? X minus 13 equal to 0. Put them one by one equal to 0 to get two answers. If either x minus 14 0 or x minus 13 0, this will give two values, x 14 and x 13. So we have two options for x, but we have tried two numbers. So we have to divide question into two parts. So I'm going to erase that and we will divide our question into two parts. See how? Case number one. If our x is first option, that is 14, then in that case, therefore first number which you used as x, it will be 14. Second number, you marked it as 27 minus x, or 27 minus 14 will give 13. Similarly, you can perform the same work in case number 2. If x is 13, then in that case first number, therefore first number, it will be x or 13. Second number, it will be 27 minus x or 27 minus 13. Lastly, answer will be 14. So this was our third question, which was the easiest one, we can say. There is no difficulty to understand this. Try to understand all these concepts by writing them once again by yourself. Now I'm going further for question number 4 after this. Question number 4 is, find two consecutive positive integers, sum of whose squares is 365. Consecutive means in order. First, then next, second, like 1, 2, 3. They are in order. 1, 2, 3, they are consecutive numbers. 4, 5, 6, they are consecutive numbers. So, consecutive means in order. Then, sum of whose squares is 365. Sum of whose square means, first of all, we need two consecutive integers. And they should be positive. They have written here positive integers. Let's start by writing this solution, okay, of this fourth. I'm going to start. Let x, if I am writing x as first integer, then next will be x plus 1 in order, okay, in succession. I have to write that x and x plus 1 be two consecutive positive integers. So they are consecutive positive integers, but in the question it is clearly given, they have given sum of whose, sum of whose squares. Whose squares means sum of squares of these two given numbers is 365. And what are the numbers? X and x plus 1. So we have to write equation by using this given. So write x square. Here you have to use formula a plus b whole square. That is a square plus b square plus 2ab. Use this formula here. So a square means x square plus 1 square plus 2 into x into 1. And there you have 365. I am shifting here in this left side. So I am writing minus 365 in the left side equal to 0. This will be x square plus 1 plus 2x minus 365 equal to 0. X square, this will give 2x square and 2x after this, and 1 minus 365 will give minus 364 equal to 0. Then this whole has 2 common. What is left inside? X square plus x minus, this will give 182 with minus sign equal to 0. Shift 2 there, it will give x square plus x minus 182 equal to 0 over 2, or we can say it is 0. Then you have to factorize this quadratic's middle term. But for that, you have to write first product of first and last term. X square into minus 182. Its product is minus 182 x square. So then repeat these two as I marked here, x square and minus 182. Then you have to divide this x into two parts so that their product gave minus 182 x square and their sum or difference gives this x only. So there are two numbers only which we used earlier in question number 3. They are 14 and 13. But what do you need? You need plus x. So you have right here 14x with positive sign and 13x with negative sign, because 14x into minus 13x will give minus 182x square. They are the numbers. So I am writing here plus 14x minus 13x. Then form pairs. From first pair x common, x plus 14 left. From last to minus 13 common, x plus 14 left equal to 0. X plus 14, then x minus 13 equal to 0. So this is our calculation. Now we have to continue our work for two answers of x. So I'm going to erase this, because I hope you are understanding these things. We are going to use this space for next calculation. See what is given. Either x plus 14 equal to 0 or x minus 13 equal to 0. And first will give x minus 14 and the second one will give x 13. But see, here you have x negative. It is clearly given our integers are positive, but this is negative integers. So we will write here rejecting. We are going to reject this value because given integers are, what are they? Yes, are positive. So we are going to reject it. So our final answer of x is 13. And if we have answer of x, we can easily give answer of this line which we marked earlier. Therefore, consecutive, or you can mark two consecutive integers are, what are they? X and x plus 1, that is 13, and 13 plus 1, or we can say 13 and 14. This is our required answer of question number 4. It is also the easiest one. There is no difficulty because almost the same calculation in 3rd and 4th we have, except marking here. So remember this step, this one, and you will be able to solve it further till end. It is not a difficult work. So try to solve once again by yourself. Okay, I can only suggest to you, you can solve it once again. Try to understand, if in one calculation okay, you just work hard, then there will not be any difficulty in any calculation of this kind. So we are going further for next question number 5 after this. Our next question number 5 is, the altitude of a right triangle is 7 cm less than its base. So it is very clearly given, altitude of a right triangle. So triangle is right angled. Let's draw it first, okay, then we will see what is given next. So I am going to draw one right angle triangle. So let's draw, okay, a margin here. We will divide it in two parts here. So here I am going to write first calculation. So see, there is a right angled triangle given. Let's draw one right angled triangle, and no doubt this will be the base. Here it will be hypotenuse, and the last one here it will be altitude. So write these here first. Now see what is given. The altitude of a right triangle is 7 cm less. This altitude is 7 cm less than its base. Do you have its base? Base we don't have. Suppose its base is x centimeter, then altitude will be 7 less, means x minus 7 cm. Then they have given, if the hypotenuse is 13 cm, hypotenuse given 13 cm. Now they are writing find the other two sides. So other two sides means hypotenuse given, base and altitude. But they are having symbol x. If you have x, you can easily give answer of these two. So we have to write our calculation for x first, then we will give their answers. Let's start by writing x. Let base equal to x centimeter. Therefore altitude will be x minus 7 centimeters, and hypotenuse is 13 centimeter given. But you know, this triangle is right angled. In right angle triangle, which property we can use, which theorem we can use, try to remember Pythagoras theorem. In right angle triangles, most of the times we will see use of Pythagoras theorem. So in this right triangle whose name you can give, or that's your wish. If you don't want, I am not giving any name to this, you can mark ABC, then you can mention name here, but I think there is no need. So we are writing right triangle by Pythagoras theorem. What Pythagoras theorem says? Yes, hypotenuse square equal to base square plus perpendicular or altitude square. So we have to fill values here. Hypotenuse 13 centimeter square, and base you used as x centimeter square. Then altitude, what is altitude? X minus 7 centimeter square. Then 13 squares, 169 centimeter square. It will be x square centimeter square, and it is x minus 7 whole square centimeter square. Then 169 centimeter square, and I am writing combinedly centimeter square out to cancel it with the left side. And here x square. What about formula for this a minus b whole square? It is a square plus b square minus 2ab, means 2 into x into 7, you can mark here using, because a minus b whole square, a square plus b square minus 2ab. It is optional, you can mark if you want, otherwise not compulsory, okay? So 169 of left side is equal to x square plus x square, 2x square, 7 square, 49. So I'm writing plus 49 here. Then minus 2 into 7, 14x, minus 14x. Now we will shift 149 there in the right side. So 0 equal to 2x square. I'm writing minus 14x first, then plus 49 minus 169. Let's rewrite it. I'm going to solve this. 2x square minus 14x, and this one, 49 and 169 will give minus 120 equal to 0. For the c, they all have 2 common, so I'm going to take 2 out. X square minus 7x minus 60 equal to 0. See, all the signs are properly marked or not? They are accurate, okay? So 2 you can shift there, it will be x square minus 7x minus 60 equal to 0 over 2, or it will give 0. Now time is to factorize. What about product of first and last? It is, yes, minus 60 into x square, minus 60x square. Now we will factorize the middlemost value. It is minus 7x, so which can be written as minus 12x plus 5x. Students, try to learn these things, they are very much useful. Factorization of the middlemost term. Now we see what is given. From first to x common, x minus 12 left. From last to 5 common, x minus 12 left equal to 0. Then x minus 12 common, x plus 5 left equal to 0. Put them one by one equal to 0, because their product is 0, either first 0 or second 0. So either x minus 12 0 or x plus 5 0. There will be two values, x 12 and x minus 5. But you can reject this negative value. The reason is, x means you are using it as base, but length of base cannot be negative. So we have tried here rejecting. We are going to reject this, because length of a side cannot be negative. So you can mark here. Therefore our x is 12. So if x is 12, we can give answer for these two lines. Therefore base, which is x centimeter or 12 centimeter. And what about altitude? Altitude will be, yes, x minus 7 centimeter or 12 minus 7, 5 centimeter. This was question number 5. Again, the easiest one. Try to learn these things, students. They are very much useful for you. So next we are going for question number 6. Students, here is our last question number 6 of 4.2. It is, a cottage industry produces a certain number of pottery articles in a day. Means there is some number of articles produced in a day. It was observed on a particular day that the cost of production of each article was 3 more than twice the number of articles produced on that day. So on one day they observed the cost of production of one article, means how much they spent on production of that article, that was 3 more than what? Then twice the number of articles. Twice the number of articles produced on that day. Do you know how many articles they produced on that day? We don't know. Suppose number of articles produced on that day was X. So they were articles. Then cost of each article will be 3 more than twice of this number of articles. That is 2X plus 3 in rupees. This was cost of one article. What about total cost of production then? If one article cost this much, then X will cost their combination. If one article cost rupees 2x plus 3 rupees, and then X will cost rupees X into 2x plus 3. This will be cost of production. Cost of production. Or we can say total cost. So total cost of production. But it is given here. See next. If the total cost of production on that day was rupees 90, but it is given equal to 90, then we have to find the number of articles produced and the cost of each article. So let's start. This is rough work only, which I told you. Okay, you can write it along with your answer, or you can just erase it or cut it. Okay, so we are going to start it. Let number of articles produced on that day. Suppose on that day they produced X articles. Therefore, cost of each means one here, okay? One means for every article the cost will remain the same. I am going to take its meaning as one. So cost of each article rupees, but three more than twice the number of articles means 2x plus 3. This is cost of one article. Therefore, total cost of production. How much they spend for production of x articles? It will be rupees 2x plus 3 into number of articles, which will give us rupees 2x square plus 3x. This much they spend on production of these articles. But in the question given, I am writing according to question. In question given, this total cost of production, which is 2x square plus 3x, is actually on that day equal to, see what is given, rupees 90. So it is equal to rupees 90. So 90 can, rupees cancelled here. 90 we have to shift in the left side. 2x square plus 3x minus 90 equal to 0. Now, see further. First and last, if I just multiply first and last value with sign minus 90, their product will be minus 180x square. So I have to write these again, same values. But how will you factorize the middlemost 3x so that their product will be, we will divide this into two parts so that their product will be minus 180x square and their combination give us 3x. And students, remember it. I know, but you have to learn these things. So you are having these two numbers, 15x and 12x. Try to remember these because they are useful here. So form pairs, after this I am going to erase that part. We have to solve it further for answers. So we have combination of two terms from first to x common. And if you take x common, what we left inside? Yes, 2x plus 15. Now from the last two, yes, see 15 here, 15 into 6, 90, that means 6 is common. So take minus 6 out. What we left with you? 6 into 2, 12. Then x with it means 2x, then minus common, so you have plus sign here, plus 15 equal to 0. So this factor is same, 2x plus 15 common, x minus 6 will left equal to 0. Put them one by one equal to 0, either 2x plus 15 equal to 0 or x minus 6 equal to 0. So first we'll give 2x equal to minus 15 or x equal to 6. We have first answer here, and x equal to minus 15 over 2. But we have to reject it. What is the reason? We are going to reject it. Okay, I am going to write here rejecting. Why? Because x means number of articles, and number of articles cannot be negative. So you can give reason, because number of articles cannot be negative. So we have this reason to leave. So we have x equal to 6. Then time is to give answer. So I am going to use these two lines. Therefore, you can start from here. Number of articles produced on that day equal to x or 6. And cost of each article, it will be, yes, rupees 2x plus 3. Or you marked it as, okay, previous calculation. So I am going to write here 2x plus 3. It will be rupees 2 into 6 plus 3, x means 6, so it will give rupees 12 plus 3 or rupees 15. This will be the cost of each article on that day. This was question number 6. I hope you enjoyed this video. I tried to explain in easiest way, but still there is a need of your hard work. Try to remember these things by writing once again by yourself. And don't forget to subscribe the channel and press the bell icon for latest notifications. Bye bye.